to our class today. Today we'll be having English studies, and you know, in our previous class we were talking about pronouns and their various types. We talked about subject pronouns, we talked about object pronouns. So today we'll be looking at reflexive pronouns and of course the possessive pronouns. So reflexive pronouns redirect a sentence back to the subject, in which the subject now becomes the object of the sentence. What am I trying to say? Reflexive pronouns comes when the subject performs an action upon itself. Remember that I told you that a subject is the doer of an action, okay? And the object is the receiver of an action. So that means two different people in a sentence. But reflexive pronouns, in reflexive pronouns, the sentence is about the subject, but also the subject becomes the object. That's why we said it redirects a sentence so that the subject now becomes our object. I hope that's clear. So let's look at the following examples. We also said that it performs an action, the subject performs an action upon himself. Alright? Now look at examples here. We have, since she is our own boss, she gave herself a raise. Since she is our own boss, she gave herself a raise. Now, our major subject here is this person, she here, isn't it? Now, she did something to her own self. That's why we said he performs an action upon his own self. So, she did what? She gave herself a raise. So, herself here becomes an example of a reflexive pronoun. The second example, she allowed herself more time to get ready. She allowed herself more time to get ready. So she's our subject. And what did she do? She did something to herself, isn't it? She took more time for herself to get ready. So herself also here becomes our reflexive pronoun. Our third example, the computer restarts itself every night. The computer restarts itself every night. So the computer is our subject of the sentence, and it does something to itself, so it becomes the subject and of course the object in our sentence. So we use itself here, becomes our reflexive pronoun. Now let's look at our possessive pronouns. This replaces the nouns of possessive adjectives. It replaces those nouns of possessive adjectives. Now these are examples of what possessive adjectives are. When we say possessive, of course you know what it means. It means that something belongs to you. Something belongs to you. It is your own, okay? So in doing that, in saying that, you use words like my, showing that it is yours. Ours, showing that maybe it's for you and someone else. Your, showing that it belongs to someone else. Her, his, and their, okay? Now, these are adjectives of possessive adjectives, okay? Now, possessive pronouns change these following possessive adjectives to the following, where my becomes mine, our becomes ours, your becomes yours, her becomes hers, his still remains his, we have it. And there becomes theirs. Also, possessive pronoun can also be whose as against who. Instead of saying who owns this bag, we could say whose bag is this. Now let's look at examples of possessive pronouns. I thought my bag was lost, but the one Kevin found is mine. I thought my bag was lost, but the one Kevin found is mine. Now, you can see mine here, isn't it? That is the possessive adjective. But it changed finally to a possessive pronoun, mine. So this sentence becomes a pronoun, mine becomes a pronoun, but a possessive pronoun. Now, look at the second example. Their vacation will start next week. Ours is tomorrow. Their vacation will start next week. Ours is tomorrow. So, ours here, remember I told you that it replaces the possessive adjective our. So, ours here makes this sentence an example of a possessive pronoun. That's the end of our class today. In the course of the class, if you have any questions, please feel free to answer or ask me and I'll answer them. Thank you.